Over its 125-year history, the Star Island Pier has served us well, but it has not escaped the wear and tear of the ocean, and in particular of winter storms. This wear and tear was most obvious along the northwest corner of the pier, and in fact, we had anticipated budgeting funds on an annual basis to repair some of the damage along this section. In March of 2001, a severe winter storm caused significant damage not to the northwest corner of the pier, but to the northeast corner of the pier, a part of the pier that we thought was in fact quite stable. During this storm, several large granite blocks were ripped out by the wave action, and the result was that the entire head of the pier was deemed by two different engineering firms to no longer be safe for use. We made plans for a temporary docking arrangement so that we could conduct island business as usual without actually using the pier itself.
This is the start of the project. That's Steve Durrell, who is what's your official title?
Project
manager from Proc Marine. And this is one of the crew from Proc. And out on deck we've got two of the engineers from Applehart.
How high are the swells, guys?
Well, we're having a semantic debate.
16 to 20 foot seas.
Well, they were last Monday. We've got a day when they left. Bad putting his nose up.
Oh, man.
Really?
Yeah, that's when they turned around and came back.
Well, you had 10 foot seas, didn't you?
Yeah.
This is barge number 7 from Proc Marine Company in the tug Dorothy Hill. The barge is 48 feet wide, 120 feet long. We've currently got about 600 ton of granite on board. The tug is a 65-foot tug. Both vessels are out of Rockland, Maine.
What do you want to do, Dave? Just spring onto it like usual?
Yeah, granite comes from Crotch Island in Stonington, Maine. We'll take those blocks and we'll cut them to certain sizes to fit the pier as we need them as we go along.
Okay, so,
hey.
Here we are.
Good, how
How's it going?
That's going good.
Yeah, do you need...
The 60 feet is, you know, where the 60 feet starts and finishes, and just go over all of that.
Yep, okay, that's what I think we ought to do.
Yeah. The seawater intake has all been moved.
It's all gone, yep.
Okay, utility sheds have been moved.
Yep.
Looks like everything's been done.
Yep.
Let's go look at those defenders up there. Neoprene rubbers have got to be saved.
But we'll do that. We'll pull them off.
Yeah, they'll pull them off. Just set them up.
Come on, 60 feet. 60 feet.
As the work crew loaded their supplies and their food in the bucket of the backhoe, the rest of us went off to find the survey marker.
Is it, Nick? That's it. Okay, we're there.
Detail is going to start at the 60-foot area here, you know, this section, and this one's going to start over there, and somewhere in between here you're going to find some good material, we hope, and you'll transition from one to the other.
When I figured the job, you know, I figured reusing most of this out here with roughly 10% new stone, and then all of this down here was new stone.
The guy's going to cut all the rock. You can see down the side of that rock a series of little holes. Right along that top edge, we use what we call feathers and wedges. They're just two tapered pieces of steel with a steel wedge. These drop down in the hole. That wedge starts in on top. You just run along and hit them with them all.
Well, it feels good to finally get started. We're running about 3 weeks behind the schedule, but at least we're here, started, and so we know it's all going to be in place by the season, even if we're finishing it up when the season first started.
See you later, Jerry.
Thank you.
Episode begin.
when we returned for our regular construction meeting on the island, we were pleased to see just how much work had been done.
See what they did? They run fill out.
Yeah.
And they lay up a little wall on it. Backfill it and build a wall up, backfill it and build a wall. Yeah. All it is a face wall with rubble.
And that's the size of the face wall?
Most of the rock we took out of here isn't that big.
Really?
There it is. Wow.
These are several times the size of the stones we're using.
This stuff weighs 160 pounds a cubic foot. So you gotta figure those are probably at least 10 feet.
Yeah.
And they're 38 inches thick, 3 feet wide. So if you went.
I was just saying, is that rubbing off on you, buddy?
90 cubic feet and 160 pounds a cube.
You gonna set another stone down?
We were joined by Dave Pearson, who is a veteran of many pier repair projects.
Looks good from here.
The only part of this, from 60 feet back from the head of the pier, the only part that's being left is this side right here. But when you get out to where the head of the pier is, everything in the head of the pier is coming off and being completely reconstructed. And all you can see the head of the pier now is just that stone sticking out right on the end. The rest is all covered in the rubble.
Reinforcement steel is put in before we pour a concrete slab on the deck, and it basically helps bond and reinforce the concrete from breaking up and keeps it in the smallest pieces. Basically works along the same lines as auto safety glass, I guess.
As we left the island that day and we looked at stones that had been placed in the pier more than a century ago by people who were building for the future, we realized that we too are building for the future and laying stones that we trust will be serving people a century and perhaps even two centuries from now. The work that we're doing on the pier now is the work of good stewards. It honors those who have come before us and dedicated years and years of their lives to preserving the traditions and the foundations of Star. And the work that we're doing now is laying a strong foundation to make possible stewardship by people who will come after us.